get at it. Let's get at it.
Yeah.
We have got, so here's the scenario. It's summertime. We have a little segment that we like to do called Steal, Stash, and Gorilla's Goods. We like to just try new shit. Sometimes things that we have that he hasn't tried or that he has that I haven't tried, and kind of review it and give you guys something to look at as we're going through the summer. And we're sticking with the summer theme. So I got a buddy. I've never tried a mojito. Never. And I've had more than my fair share of adult beverages.
Oh yeah.
but anyway, so he's like, hey man, why don't you try a mojito? It's a great summer drink. And anyway, suggested it to Steel, and Steel's like, let's get it. So Steel, you've got a recipe. Tell us what a mojito
is. Let me fire this puppy up. So this is just a regular, you know, everyone uses all recipes and they're pretty good. But this puppy, it's real simple. It's a bit of mint leaves. It says 10, but I mean, everything, kind of take this with a grain of salt, no pun intended. It's whatever, it's preference. But some mint leaves, half a lime, cut it into 4 wedges. I mean, it gets pretty specific. 2 tablespoons of sugar. Now, hold the phone here. I just did this, and it's way too sweet for me.
Yep.
I would go 1 if I was to do this again.
That's what I did, one tablespoon. I'm not a sweet guy.
Me neither.
At least.
I want to taste that rum.
Exactly. Give me I want something on my chest,
Yeah, me too. Ice cubes, put a couple ice cubes in there, and then 1.5 ounces of rum. I mean, I went too.
I may have went a bit more. Just saying.
Just saying.
It is Friday night stream party after this, so fuck it.
Diabetes, yeah. You ain't lying, Chris. But then some soda water. Half a cup, but whatever. I mean, it depends on what size glass obviously you're using. But I just top it off with soda water. And you give that a little, you got a little stirry stir. This is kind of what it looks like. It's just a bunch of mashed up mint. And some lime in there, and let's not take it rip.
Yeah, I can't lie. I've been already drinking this shit, and it's delicious.
Me too.
It's so good.
Me too. It is so good.
So good.
I don't know. It's good. So far, everything we've done, I mean, excluding the steak, because that was phenomenal. But for the drinks, my favorite's been the Tom Collins. I still have mix in the fridge. I made another 2 liters of that shit last week.
Oh, the Tom Collins is phenomenal, hands down. So we're going to keep with this theme. And next week, stick with this. If you're interested in this, if you like to cook, I'm a big cook. I've got steak knives or the kitchen knives, you know, the fancy stuff. I love to cook. Next week, guys, so I'm taking something from where I live, and I'm going to deliver it to Steel.
Yeah, tell us about it.
Welcome to the Southwest. This is going to be awesome. Golf, you're going to love this shit then. So we make a Southwest steak with a roasted pepper, mashed potatoes, and fire-roasted tomatillos. Unbelievable. So we're going to have a little bit different episode. We're actually going to film it as we're making it and put it all together for you. And so you guys will all be making this 2 nights. And I'm going to throw this all together. It's my own special little recipe that I make. I did bite off a few people, but I added my own sauce to it. Anyway,
we'll post
so
the recipe in the episode.
Because this shit is legit. I'm talking
I can't wait.
Legit.
You were sending me pictures and ingredients and stuff, and I was like, tell me more. Tell me more.
Right? Well, man, I'm excited about right now. I've been keeping track of this the whole time. It's time for some sports. It is definitely times. Right, Tom, until you had me a cook. My girl says I love this.
Ooh, let's go, surfer. Send it to us, man. Maybe
let's get some.
Maybe we can whip that. Yeah, we can whip that puppy up. Maybe.
Hell yeah! But I'm excited. I'm excited. Mm-hmm. The NHL playoffs are here, and I am so stoked right now. The Golden Knights are winning right now. I just got to throw. We're not covering them until the second part of it because we got the Leafs, but they're on it, baby. They are
let's
on
go.
It. Yeah,
go Knights, go.
Anyway, let's get to it. Let's definitely get to it. Let's get the video up here. Okay. What do we got going on, man?
So, game 5.
Who is this? Who is
this? Maple is Toronto, Leafs. Montreal. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Game five, the boys were down 3-1 and brought it back to 3-3, as you just saw there in the highlight. And unfortunately, things didn't go their way, and they lost in overtime. I can already hear Maritime Mogul chuckling because he's a big Habs guy. Shout out Maritime Mogul. So now we're going back to game six at Montreal. It's actually going to be the first game with fans for any Canadian team in this year. So kind of interesting. It'll be cool to see how that's like. But I feel like the Leafs are going to bounce back. I hope they come back with a more solid effort. The first period just didn't cut it in game five, and they just couldn't really get out of that, climb that that hill in time. So I really think we're going to see a totally different Leafs team in game six. Might even see a few guys who have been missing. Nick Foligno, huge piece. He's been hurt. So they're talking about maybe him coming back. I can't wait, man. I'm so excited for Saturday. I know my boy Chris Maritime Mogul is just teaming here. And our good friend Dixie, big Habs fan as well. And he'll be watching.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm working on it. We might have a surprise guest. I'm working on it right now.
We've got a man in the stands, don't we?
We do. We got a man at game seven of the Golden Knights versus Wild in Vegas right now. And I'm stoked. Anyway, I'm trying to set that up so we can get some video from in the stadium.
You see what Maritime just said about the ticket prices in Montreal for game six?
Shut the front door. 9,300 bones.
Yeah, I heard.
That's Super Bowl.
Yeah, it's insane. I'm pretty big. Like, I follow a lot of people on Leafs Twitter, and there's some people I follow from the greater Toronto area that bought tickets and are going to Montreal to see it. And I want to know what they paid to buy them from Montreal fans. It's probably a car, a brand new car.
Absolutely. I'll tell you, y'all Canadians are crazy about hockey up there. Y'all shit going crazy.
Yeah. Look, here's some Knights. Knights highlights. Yeah. This is game six, right?
This is game six. They got shut out. They were up 3-1, wild comeback, two games in a row, shut them out in game six, forces to game seven. They're in game seven right now. I'm so excited. It's awesome. The score is 4-2. If you're interested in that, I'm not watching it. They are in end of the second, so they're getting ready to join in. Okay. I'm trying to work with get some film. He's in the stadium. I'm kind of geeked about that. That doesn't happen very often on many talk shows unless you're kind of on the bigger end of it. So for us little guys, I'm really excited about it. So
Mike, y'all Canadians,
yeah.
Y'all absolutely Canadians.
So they've been in. They got worked. I mean, they absolutely got worked in this game. It was uglier than a men's fence post. It was great up until the third period. Then all of a sudden, the wheels just fell off. And that's why we're at game seven. And I'm excited about it. It's interesting still. You predicted first segment we did.
Yep.
You said this is going seven.
Before the playoffs, a week or two before they even started.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you and so I was stoked about it. So yeah, 4-2, end of the second period for the Golden Knights. That's my team, Matt Cookin. Matt, he's been on the show. You see him stream with us. He sucks at the game, but he's a great freaking guy, so we tolerate him. He gets high 90% of the time.
We love you, Maddie. If you guys have ever watched our bloopers video, we've got a scene in there where I blow up Attack Rover with an RPG, and Matt's mid bong rip, and he just goes.
All right. Yeah, he's a great shot. Look who just joined us. I'm gonna switch this over.
We are live from T-Mobile.
Oh, here we are, Cookin Matt. What's going on? It's connecting the audio.
What up?
What's up?
Oh, Knights, go, baby!
Yeah,
we're at game seven.
Wow! How
Knights in the Wild?
Awesome. How's the game?
We're up 4-2 right now. We were tied at the beginning of the first period, 1-1.
Okay.
We went up and scored a goal by Hague. It was 2-1.
Yeah.
Then we tied it, or should I say Minnesota tied it. Then Max Pacioretty, his first game back from the beginning of the series, scores his first goal, makes it 3-2. And then we have White Cloud who scores again and makes it 4-2. So we are up 4-2 right now at the end of the second period.
Oh, shut up, man. How are they playing? How are the Knights playing? Are they playing well?
They're doing good, man. They're playing great defense, great offense. They're doing awesome.
Let's go.
Oh, my God, man. That's awesome. Now, the real question I have for you, Maddie, how high are you?
Pretty blitzed, yeah. Yeah. Smoke some bowls, make a couple drinks.
Yeah.
You know, the whole crew. This is my buddies right here behind me. Say hello, everybody.
Let's go Steel and Gorilla Gaming Show.
Yeah, get us a Go Gorilla and Steel and Gorilla Gaming Show, Maddie.
All right, give me 1 second.
Yeah.
Can we get a Go Nuts Go here? Oh, let's get a chant going, everybody!
Let's go!
Go! Knights, go!
Yeah!
Go!
Yeah!
Go! Go! Knights, go! Go! Knights, go! Yeah, baby!
Yeah!
All right, guys, it was calling into you guys. I'll talk to y'all later. Have a good night.
Thanks, man. Take care, Maddie.
Knights.
Absolutely.
That was fucking awesome.
Unbelievable.
Did that just happen?
I love that fucking guy. I love that guy like you wouldn't believe.
Matt's a beauty. He's been around with us since day one. Him and Frilla actually go way back. And
We've been playing almost 10 years with each other. We met each other gaming, and now we're friends. We go visit each other all the time. But anyway, we spent a lot of time on there. We'll really kind of just wrap this up. Sure. I don't even know if we get into the basketball just because we spent a lot of time on the damn on the Knights, but shit.
If you want to cover the Suns and Lakers, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, well, we got the Jazz. I mean, the Jazz are my team, obviously, because I'm from Utah. You know, they came back. They lost the first game without Donovan Mitchell, that cat right there. Let me get to the news and video. You're going to like that a lot better. It's going to be better for everybody. Anyway, he came back and they dropped 141 on Minnesota, blew him out. It wasn't even close.
Is that a playoff record for points for one team in a playoff game?
You know, I don't think so.
That's
a
lot.
Yeah, back in the 80s, man, you had a couple of those times, man, where basketball was up in the 160s.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know the exact record on that, but man, Donovan Mitchell's back. Really excited about the prospect of the Utah Jazz going. And then, you know, the interesting one, so they're up, the series is tied 1-1. They play 2 days from now. And the other one that's big because it's for you is the
Suns and the Lakers
series. And what's going on there still, man? You thought the Suns would handle
it. Suns look good, game one. And then, LeBron, right? Mm-hmm. And they run off two in a row. Chris Paul not too happy with the foul calling. Quite a discrepancy. But
watch
I don't know, man.
LeBron. Look at that. Just a fadeaway three to start the game. Welcome back, buddy.
Welcome back. I mean, the Chris Paul stuff, like,
oh,
I don't know, man.
What the hell was that all about?
Call you have to call the games the way you see it, right? You can't have makeup calls. So if they're committing the fouls, like, they got to call them. It's not the Lakers' responsibility to make sure the calls go even, right?
You know, here's the scenario. I looked at that because I'm always into that sort of thing. But, you know, I looked up the stats. It was 30-18 on free throw attempts. And, I mean, a 12.
It's odd.
Yeah, I mean, it's a little off, but not hugely off. But here's my philosophy on that shit. In any sport, anything you do, if you don't like losing, play better. You know, that's it. Don't bitch about this. Don't bitch about that. You worry about what you can control.
They officiate how they officiate if you got to adapt to that.
Absolutely. So I was a little disappointed in Chris Paul saying that, but you know, excuses are like assholes. Everyone's got one and everyone stinks. I don't want to hear it. But
Maritime with the facts here. Apparently the record is 157 by the 1990 Celtics.
Nice. See, there you go.
Yep.
I mean, there was a point where offense was outrageous. So the other series that is big on me is, and not to spend a lot more time on it, but it's huge, is the Dallas Mavericks are wrecking the LA Clippers. They are
Dirk 2.0
on steroids. Luka Doncic. I'm not gonna lie. This cat, he dropped 39, 7, and 7. Again, he had a triple double in the first game. He's single handling, dismantling the Mavericks or the Clippers. The Clippers just—they don't have an answer. They're not playing team ball. I watched the games and I was just disappointed. Unless they can turn it around, unless they can find a way to make it better, that series is over. It's over. Clippers, it might go six, but because you're not gonna win every one of them. But it's over if they can't turn around. What were you gonna say, Steele, right there?
I was just gonna say, like you touched on it already, and then I'm gonna be honest. I'm not a huge fan, but I've been doing a lot of research and watching ever since we started the show. And I think the problem with the Clippers is they're too many individuals. They're not really a team.
Yeah, and it's that is, and you know,
yep. Paul George. Dallas is, I mean, mind you, I mean, the dude is just destroying everybody, but it's a team effort too.
Absolutely, and that they're playing team ball, and team ball, you know, just like in Warzone, just like in anything that you're trying to accomplish, if you're not part of the team, you're part of the problem, and that's not a good success recipe for success. So. No. You know, I'm excited about this. I'm excited about the Knights. Another great show. If anybody's in the chat, you guys got anything we want to talk about, let us go.
What did you guys think? First night affiliated. Thank you, everybody, so much for the support. Holy crap. What did you guys think? What, you got any thoughts, ideas? What do you want us to do next? UFC? We got a big pay-per-view. Is it? Oh, man, you put me on the spot now, Chris. I think it's June 12th.
UFC?
Yeah, I think it's UFC 263 on June 12th. Izzy versus Vittori. June 16th. There you go. Yeah, it's Israel Adesanya coming back to middleweight to defend his belt against Marvin Vittori, coming off a couple of impressive wins. That's the headliner. Then you've got, holy crap, who else is fighting in there? There's two title fights. I remember looking at the card and being like, holy smokes, it's stacked. Here, let me fire this up one sec, folks. It's and then 264 is the Conor McGregor and Poirier one. That's in July.
Yeah, I'm excited.
That's right. Nate Diaz return against what's his face? Leon Edwards.
Nate Diaz is coming back.
Nate Diaz with his 4.5 brain cells is going to step into the octagon against Leon Edwards.
I hope he doesn't win. That was a great fight. Yeah, but that's what you're going to get out of that.
The Stockton, what does he call himself? The Stockton Prince or something? I don't know what he, anyway. Yeah. He's a character. I think Leon's going to kill him. I don't think Nate lasts the full three rounds. And then this is the fight. I can't believe I forgot this right off the rip. I should have known this. But Davison Figueiredo versus Brandon Moreno, number two. The last one was a majority draw or something like that. It wasn't a – so Figueiredo kept the belt. But that was like – I don't think it was fight of the year, but it was like top three fights of the year. So they're going to run that back again.
That's awesome. Now someone's got to bloody up the ring, right? This is still getting at it. You know, if you're watching,
she's a huge fan.
That's what
Mrs.
I'm
Steele's
say.
A big UFC a big fan.
Hey, I've got to say this, and I meant to do this at the beginning. We had some sound difficulties. We're trying out a new way to program so Steele can watch the videos. Complicated, man. It's complicated doing this sort of thing when you don't have a big production unit. Anyway, I want to say, Mrs. Steele, Rach, you're a boss. Rach has single-handedly put everything that we do on podcast. Rach, hero move, legend move. That was awesome. Yeah. Steele, where can we find it? You guys know more about it than I do. I've kind of turned that over to you guys.
Yeah, no, I really appreciate, everything that my wife, Rachel, Mrs. Steele, has done for us.
Snails.
She's our quality control. We run ideas off of her. She proofreads a lot of our stuff. She got our Instagram up and running. She got us on podcasts. We're on pretty much every podcatcher you can get. We're on Stitcher, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Play. Just search Steele and Gorilla Gaming Show and you'll find it. We drop the basically what we do is we take the video file from every week and just turn it into an MP3 and just post that on our RSS feed, and then it uploads to all the podcast sites. And it's a good way to listen to the show if you don't have time. Not everybody has time to sit down for 2.5 hours and watch us carry on with our nonsense. But
that's true. That's fair. Yeah. That's fair.
If you got some yard work to do, you know, it's springtime in Canada. Everyone's getting their flower beds going and getting the lawn mowed and shit. If you got a drive or something, it's very listenable. Honestly, I wasn't sure if a gaming show would be consumable just with audio, but it is actually pretty good on audio.
Yeah, and And Rach, Mrs. Steele, from me, you know, we talk occasionally. You hear me and my loud mouth every now and then. Well, actually, as much as Steele, I talk every day. Appreciate you. That was just legendary. And I just wanted to give a big props to Mrs. Steele on that.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, Rach, you're a hero. And I appreciate your support and Steele in this whole endeavor. I think we got a little bit of something. Mm-hmm. Anyway, hey. It is now time for the Friday night stream party. Grab your drinks.
I feel like we need to like rip off our clothes.
I do. Absolutely, right? We got to change it all up. We are gonna switch over. We appreciate everybody joining the show. We're gonna jump on some games, Surfer. I hope you're ready. Get up on it. I got my game
Chris,
fired up.
Chris, you want to play?
Yeah, is Chris jumping on with us?
I don't know if you're still there, Chris. Just type in the chat. If anybody else wants to play that's in the chat, we can get a rotation in. Mike, if you want to play, who else?
Absolutely. We don't know how many games we're going to win or what we're going to do, but God, we're going to have some drinks and some good conversation. I'm going to keep the night's game up so I can watch that shit. Anyway, everybody, thank you. We'll be switching over in just about 30 seconds.